step in. Hey!
Of course, we live in a desert. The areas that we irrigate, the old timers, the pioneers came here and established infrastructure, canals and whatnot, ditches to make it possible to irrigate some of these areas. And in so doing, they were able to stay in the area. We've used them for years and years, those same structures that they constructed. But with the growth, the need for more water is evident.
For nearly 150 years, people have been drawn to southern Utah like bees to honey. They come for its red rock scenery, sunny weather, and easy lifestyle. They stay for its strong economy, cultural activities, educational opportunities, and quality of life. With increased population, there comes an increasing demand for water.
Many have heard me say many times that the grease that runs an economy isn't grease, it's water. And water is critical to whatever happens in any economy. No economy or no society outgrows its water supply. The wiser you use that water, the better off that economy is going to be over the long haul. And not only is it important, but you look at the impact, an acre foot of water as it rolls through the economy that provides the jobs and supports the schools and the school teachers and the grocery clerks, the impact is huge economically within a county as you look at the economic impact of adequate water to meet the growth.
Well, water's always been important in St. George, and development of water is what's allowed the next development to occur in St. George, and it's allowed the economic vitality that we have today.
Not only is southern Utah the fastest growing area in the state, it's also one of the fastest growing areas in the country. In fact, if new sources of water are not pursued, it's estimated that this region will begin to run short as early as 2012.
If you take a look at our growth patterns here in Washington County, if you go back to 1973, when the county was about 13,000 people, we're now at about 130,000 people. So we've doubled population roughly about every 10 to 12 years since 1973.
Kanab City, for example, has a population of around 4,000. The estimated growth at build-out is 50,000 in population. If that happens, we're going to be way short on all of our infrastructure, and especially water.
We're no longer a secret anymore. The word is out, and Cedar City is on its way. If you took all of the areas that's incorporated within our city limits, and they were developed, as they will be, then we're 29% over the water rights that we have. If we developed all the land that the county would like us to annex into the city, then it's going to require nearly three times as much water capacity as we have.
To accommodate southern Utah's growing water needs, the state is planning a pipeline that would allow Utah to tap into its unused portion of Colorado River water. The Lake Powell pipeline would consist of roughly 120 miles of 66-inch pipe from Lake Powell to Sand Hollow Reservoir near St. George, and 38 miles of 30-inch pipe from Sand Hollow to Cedar City, delivering water to Kane, Washington, and Iron counties. Even though the pipeline will take only 3 years to actually build, we need to start now because it will take at least 7 years to plan and do the groundwork. It's estimated that the total cost will exceed $494 million in today's dollars.
With conservation, with ag conversion, we still find ourselves way short of enough water to meet the future growth needs in this part of the state. And because of that, we're going to need to develop a new water supply. And we get looking around at what that new supply options are. And the one that comes out every time is bringing water from Lake Powell over to Washington County. That's a long distance, and it's going to be very costly. But if we can get the water over to there, then we can distribute it throughout Washington County. We can get some more into Kane County as we go by the county, and then we can move it up to Iron County, the Cedar City area, as that need develops also.
Many say, well, why is this just a Washington County project? But when you look at the players in the project, it really is a Southwest Utah. It has Kane County, it has Iron County, Washington County, and the state is an important player in that process. And in order to make it work, it really requires a partnership of people collaboratively working for a common cause, and consistently since the inception of the Lake Powell idea, which really came out of the State Board of Water Resource staff, we've been working in partnership to evaluate the feasibility, to find the water rights, to look at how this thing should best be laid out. We think we've created a win-win-win scenario here, both for the residents here and the state as a whole, as we look at the project.
King County is actually blessed with some water. The negative side of that is it's difficult to develop because of all the public lands in this area here. So the Lake Powell Pipeline provides an opportunity for us to partner with two other counties and to be able to bring good, clean, culinary water to the citizens of King County and provide for the growth that we know that's going to come in this county.
One of the key aspects of the Lake Powell water, it allows us as a community to pick up our share of Lake Powell and use that to sustain lifestyle, to continue to grow, and to accommodate those of our families who choose to make Cedar City their home.
The Lake Powell Pipeline allows us to use a portion of our undeveloped Colorado River allocation. That pipeline will allow us to pump the water out of Lake Powell, lift it 2,500 feet, and convey it in a pipeline all the way to Sand Hollow Reservoir. Through that process, we can develop maybe as much as 100,000 acre feet of our Colorado River allocation.
Our pioneer forefathers planned ahead. They planned reservoirs, they planned structures for water delivery. We need to be planning ahead just as they did. They thought 50 and 100 years ahead. Many of the existing dams that we use in the state of Utah are 100 years old. Well, just as they thought ahead and are providing the resources that we use, we must be thinking ahead for the generation to follow. If we don't act now and plan ahead, we'll be left without the most important of all resources, and we'll be dry when we need water for our people.
Once it's completed, the Lake Powell Pipeline will deliver Southern Utah's future, a bright, promising, prosperous future.